Green algae get their name from the green pigment chlorophyll, which plants also contain. Green algae is very diverse and can be found in a range of sizes, shapes, and growth forms. If you take a look at a water sample under a microscope, you might be amazed at the diverse constellation of green algae that you'll see. Now, people can get a little freaked out about green algae. This is mostly because when it's in full force, it can form large, snot-like metaphytic blooms. Which I think is kind of cool, and it's perfectly harmless to swim in, but some people think it's pretty gross. Commonly found in Lake Scugog and worldwide, these are known as algae of the genera Zygnema, Spirogyra, and Magotia, and these different genera can be identified under the microscope by their uniquely shaped chloroplasts. But functionally, they are all the same, so you can just call them filamentous green algae. They aren't harmful in the toxic kind of way, but if filamentous green algae really take hold of an area, they can be considered a nuisance. Large blooms can actually impact aquatic ecosystems. I've seen large blooms of filamentous green algae taking over areas like in the Nan Kwan, where it can block out sunlight, restrict oxygen circulation, and thereby alter the aquatic ecosystem. Otherwise, green algae are completely harmless and feed the smallest organisms at the base of the food web, which in turn makes it a very important part of our lake.